Hi, and welcome to another C++ programming tutorial from someone9031. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to split your C++ program code into separate code files. So, up until now, every program we've written in C++ has been all within one code file, this main.cpp file. So that's perfectly fine, but if you've ever looked at anyone else's program, a program written by someone else, particularly if it's a very big program or an advanced program, you'll often notice that there are a lot more than one file. There's a lot of files, different header files, different source files. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to split up your code into different files. Now you can see here that I have a very simple circle class that I've written out. Very few things in it. You should know everything by now. And then this is the declaration up here. And then all of the implementation stuff is down here. All of the telling the functions what to do. Now when you split a program into separate files, basically, what you should do is you should put each class definition or declaration within its own header file. So you take every class, the declaration, and then you put it within its own header file. And then you put the implementation of each class within an implementation file or a .cpp file. And then you should also have your function prototypes, if you have any, also in a header file, and the function implementations within a CPP file as well. So let's go and get started. Now, to make a new header file, you go up here to Add New Item, and then you select Header File, and then you can name this what you want, but usually it should be with the name of your class, and then they should all, every header file should have an extension of either .h or .hpp or something like that. So press Add. Now under Header Files, you have a file called circle.h. Now before we add our class declaration into this, we have one thing to do, which is called an inclusion guard. We need to put an inclusion guard. And an inclusion guard basically prevents a header file from being added multiple times. So one way this can occur is if basically in main you included the circle.h file and then you went and included another header file which also included circle.h. So you're including circle.h twice because a header file can include another header file. And that's not good because that means the class here will be declared multiple times with the same name, which is not allowed in C++, so you need an inclusion guard. So to make an inclusion guard, first you put if and def, so check if it's been defined, and then after this you put basically the name of your header file in all uppercase with the dot represented as an underscore and then followed by h or hpp. Well, this can actually be anything you want it to be, as long as it's not like a system-defined constant or macro, or any other thing you've defined, because then it basically defeats the purpose, and it won't be added properly. But usually, most C++ programmers use this convention of just having the name of the header file, and since no two files may have the same name within a program, it works perfectly well. Now, so if you check if it has been defined or not, and if it hasn't been defined, then you go down here, and then you do this code. So if it hasn't been defined, that means it hasn't been included before, and you go and define it. So, yeah. Now, the next time this circle.h file is included, this will be defined because we did it down here. So this, all of this code here won't just won't compile. Now we copy over our declaration, paste it here, and end it with end if. Now we're going to make our implementation file, or our .cpp file. So click .cpp, C++ file, And then you should name this with the same name as your header file. So just go like that. And then now, to implement the class within the header file, you're going to need to include that header file. And you're going to do that within double quotes, because it is a user-defined header file. Okay, we should get rid of this now. And then we take all of this stuff, and we just cut it over. Now we paste it in here. And this implementation file does not need a inclusion guard, because it's not going to be included. And there is also one other way you can make this inclusion guard, but it's not recommended. You can get rid of all of this, this end if stuff, and then you put pound pragma, P-R-A-G-M-A, once. And that does exactly the same thing, but it's not part of the C++ standard, so it's basically based on your specific compiler. That means it's not cross-platform. Some compilers may not support it, so it might not work on all platforms or compilers. So you should just stick to the normal, the regular one, even if it is a bit more work and a bit more typing. But it is part of the C++ standard. All of these preprocessor directives that we are using are part of the C++ standard. So this code will work on any platform. So now you go up here to these three disks, which is save all, which means save every single file. We don't want to lose this. Now, in our main file, which should usually only contain the main function, it now looks a lot cleaner. Now we got to go up and include that file, include our header file. So pound include, again in double quotes, circle, .h, and you don't include the circle.cpp file, because that's just the implementation. You don't really need to include that. Well, no, you don't need to include that. And now we can use all of that circle stuff without having the actual circle class within our file. So c.setRadius equal 4. Now cout circumference and then print out the area as well. So as you can see, we don't get any errors here because these are all defined. So yeah. Okay, there's our program. Let's now go and build it. Now, some things you should know about building a program with multiple files is that basically every .cpp file is turned into its own .obj file. And then every .obj file within the program is then linked together with something called a linker, which turns it into a single program. So there we have it. That's our program. Everything works as we want it to, and our main .cpp file looks very clean with just the main function within it. So this concludes the tutorial. If you like this video, please subscribe, rate. If you have any feedback, comments, or questions about this or any other C++ topic, please feel free to leave a comment below, leave a comment on my channel, or you can message me on YouTube. Thanks for watching.